Good afternoon, friends. We are going to talk about communications for the next classes, a few classes where we'll be talking about communications, where we'll be sharing about the experiences and how one should carry on communication, which is useful in our professional as well as personal life. In that, we'll be covering many topics, which will be writing, reading, listening, and all the different types of communication, what we usually complete the whole definition. For communication, we are going to learn something about basic concept of communication, process of communication, type of formal communication, media of communication, channels of communication, barriers, and how to overcome barriers to communication. So we start with the basic concept, what exactly a communication means. It means interaction, where you share with your views, your opinions with others. That's what called is communication. India has always been a manufacturing raw resources country, but now with IT and so many other service industries coming in, and so many corporate and multinational companies coming in, there has been a total international interaction, and especially with new types of services in the market. So India, there's been a new approach and a new need is born to learn about interaction. So in that, in a business, we have to learn customer interaction skills. We have to learn international etiquette and team working skills. We have to learn the written, oral and negotiation skills, which actually complete the word communication, where you are dealing with other people of different cultures, and you need to communicate your business desires and your goals and how to get that goals reached by the group of people you're working with. It is also said that communication is very important, and it leads to the growth of personality, character, knowledge and wisdom to overcome daily roadblocks. It is like that when we communicate, it also matters how we communicate. It's not only what we communicate, but how we communicate is what is more important, and how we reach our goals by communicating and interacting with different sections of society, different stratas of working people, and in a company, how we reach to the top management and how we can inflow information to the workers who are the young executives and get the work done to the organizational goals. So this is what, let's grow with it, and this is what we are going to learn with communication with different kinds. We'll open ourselves, we'll have lot of learnings, we'll put intentions to work with our highest and to give our best and to reach our goals. As I said, communication means to share. It's a word which means communion, community. It is concerned how we make others to know our opinions, our feelings, and the information we want to disperse among the people. As for all the different works, there is a process. Same, we have a process of communication which is either formal or non-formal, or we can say informal, which is a very complex process. The message is sent may not be same as message received. So the communication has to be effective, and the fundamental for success in communication is our personal and social life. To make a successful life, we have to communicate it well, what we want to communicate and who, and whether it is received with the same value. It is right time and right communication and correctly received communication which make an organization grow. Again, this is what The process of communication would be the message are transmitted over a medium to a receiver, and next receiver next decodes the message. Feedback is started by receiver and states to the message is understood or that it must be resent. So there are three steps when we communicate, pass on the message, the receiver decodes it and then gives a feedback. In organizations, it's more of different kinds of organized way of working with it, and in personal, these are the emotions and the, you know, the different reactions we occur with, the different reactions we occur, and we reach out to the sent person, the person who started communicating the idea. As I told you, communication can be formal or informal. It can be formal, or formal communication is also termed as vertical communication. Why is it called vertical communication? I think by now you should know that when we are talking about business communication and organizations, there is a proper way, line driven and line drawn and highly motivated methods how they have placed the whole communication to take place with step by step. It is totally from up to down and down to up. So the downward communication, it is a command and control system, because this communication occurs from the management to the lower levels of the hierarchy. So it conveys orders, viewpoints of the upper level management to subordinates. There is no face-to-face communication in social as well as in personal life when we talk about the formal communication. It is here that management shows, reflects that they command, they have the controls in their hand. And this is done by regular emails and faxes to the subordinates, by posters and bulletins on the bulletin boards. If you are studying in an institution or when you were in school, you must have seen how the management or the principal wanted to announce anything and they put the write-up on the brochure or any pamphlet on the board. So that's when it is communicated what the management wants. Then house general, it's like annual general or biannual general, which they circulate over the to the students and also to the parents and also to different competitors and to the market. That's what they have been doing, and this is what their goals are, visions are for next yearly plans and the meetings and their talents in their organization. So this house general is done by the controlled by the management, the different policies, whatever the social welfare policies, the contributions by the workers and the subordinates, and whatever their vision and mission for the organization or institution is, it is done by the house general. Then they pay, insert and direct mails. Sometimes they send the direct mails also to the concerned person. Handbook and pamphlet, as I mentioned you before. Annual reports, usually in companies they hold general annual meeting, and where they all the AGMs, they are called annual general meetings, AGMs, and where all the management is present and the representatives of different departments. For example, if there is a director, there is a CEO, MD, director, and different departments, representative of financial department, there is a director of financial department, director of HR, IT, and other departments are present, and they talk about the visions and the targets and the failures and the success about the coming year, and some important representatives from other departments also, that they should know what is the plan of the management. And address system. Last but not the least, this is an address system when they call upon the whole company and they talk about personally, not one to one, but in a mass, in it's like a talk from one side to another. It's not interaction as such. It is conveying what they want and how they vision and how the new things are introduced and how they work. If sometimes when a new car is introduced and there is a address system also, when MD comes and says that we are planning to launch a new car and this is what it is and how it is better from others, and this makes a very good interaction also. But sometimes they just address and leave it there, and then the feedback start coming. In the formal communication, we also have upward communication. Jo upward communication hai, that is from, again it's a vertical communication. Wo ek line mein hi aa raha hai, linear aa raha hai, lekin wo niche se upar ja raha hai, subordinate se management ki taraf ja raha hai. And how does that function? That function with open door policies, where some of the companies, especially the socialist companies, they are social welfare companies, the policy is that they will have open talks, that they hold a date, they make a date, a target, the date is fixed, and when everybody is there and you can talk and interact and tell what exactly you want and what do you see, where do you want yourself to see and the company and all. It's an open door policy. One is when it's commonly done, and secondly when one-to-one can take appointment with the HR department, who is a representative of the management. So open door policy, that you can, for any clarification, you can directly get inside, ask for an interview, and you are given an interview or appointment, and you express and communicate whatever you want to. Second is suggestions and complaints. Aap logon ne dekha hoga ki, especially in government offices, ek suggestion or complaint ka box pada hota hai, jo shayad bahut kam use hota hai actual life mein, lekin zarur ek welfare scheme ke usme aapke ye ek suggestion box diya jata hai, aur aap apni suggestions likh sakte hain, aap apni complaints likh sakte hain, aur sometimes these complaints are directly taken by the senior most person who is an MD or CEO. They say if it's a suggestion or complaint, nobody should come in between, it should directly reach them. In fact, I was reading about Oberoi Groups, which is a hoteliers, the biggest, one of the biggest and most 7-star hotel reputation they have. And Bikki Oberoi was mentioning, who's the owner of Oberoi, and he said that all complaints and suggestions reach my table every day and I personally answer them, whether it's from clients or the persons concerned. Isn't that beautiful? That's suggestions and complaints. What it actually was introduced, it has to meet the basic requirement of reaching out. Then there are questionnaires. When HR department spreads a questionnaire either by internet, intranet system, or by papers, and then they ask the question whether you are satisfied with the thing, whether a subordinate or with the senior person, do you want any changes, what do you suggest more, how do you think the system would be better, and how do you, the new policy is this, and how do you think that this would be well received, and what is it useful about it. These are different kinds of questionnaires they distribute, and the employees, they are the clients, your customers, and they reply and send it back, so that communication becomes more direct and clear. Then ombudsperson. Ombudsperson was introduced as a person, basically a union person. Basically this concept came in 40s, 50s, when the influence of other the trade unions were raised all over the world, and then the labor class also asked their equal rights. So mostly in the second, this is 40s and 50s, that was the era when it was coming up in a big way all over the world. And they are the one, the ombudsperson is person who has access to management. He hears complaints, investigates about that complaint, and recommends appropriate actions to the management. So actually it was a very positive step taken by the management, so that there is no gap between the work, their target of work, their growth pattern, and the workers as well as the management. So this person was placed, And it is a very responsible job. It's a job which holds a lot of patience and a vision, who shares the vision of the company and also has a social welfare outlook towards the people as a group, as one, right? There are certain meetings, certain companies which hold meetings, and they are special meetings when they are asked for after a certain mishap, something which happens is not correctively taken or very well received. When you have a very successful event and you hold a special meeting for that, or a loss is seen, or it's an exigency plan when you have to do, then you ask for special meeting. This is a group thing. Or otherwise, when an individual is disturbed, jab ek individual organization mein disturb hota hai aur kisi bhi reason se, chahe apne peer group ki wajah se, chahe matlab jo aap unke saath kaam kar rahe hain equals, chahe senior ki wajah se, chahe junior ki wajah se, lekin wo ek special meeting ke liye request karta hai, appointment leta hai aur wo aage phir apna communicate karta hai, chahe written mein ya by verbal. Here another point which is upward is the representation, because there is one CEO, one MD, 5 directors, 8 general managers, and this is how the pyramid, then managers, 20 managers, and then the deputy managers and junior managers and then executives. So there, it is like a pyramid we form in any organization. In that, if you have a person who has good communication skill and he becomes the, and is clear of the demands of the people who he represent, he becomes a representative and he asks for an appointment and goes to that department and puts up his demands, his confusions and all other things, so that the communication, the target, there is a clarity in the upward and downward communication and it is well received. So that's one thing which is representation. Even ombuds person is a representative. They become representative of management, some become representative of the working group, and how the communication, the sole purpose is to have clear communication in any organization. Now we come to a little detailed process. What is a process of communication? It is divided in lateral and grapevine and diagonal. So lateral is a communication which is among the same level of people, where all executives are together. There are hotels, and as well as, especially I've seen the hotels where the management, there's a room for senior managers to have lunch, and then there's a room for non-managers to have lunch, because hotel is, most of these companies, big companies, they provide the lunch, and that time is of sharing, and that's where they, the equals, in fact I must mention it, the word mess. We always say, especially in armed forces and disciplined forces, they say that mess mein jana hai, ya mess mein kaam ho raha hai, ya mess mein reh rahe hain, party kaha hai, mess mein, infantry mess mein hai, ya navy mess mein hai. So mess was a word which says meeting of equal social status people. So it's a meeting of equal social status makes a mess. So there are the mess for the officer's mess, then for the jawan's mess, or for the different officers who are not officers, and so whatever the different kinds of mess. So that's where you feel that the people from equal social status, they meet and interact with each other. This is where, very interestingly, when you meet your equals, whether it's schools, institutions, colleges or organization, you generate rumors, you generate backbiting, you generate gossiping, ki bade wale ke saath kya ho raha hai, kis क्यों कोई चापलूस है या कहाँ कोई बातचीत हो रही है और क्या रूमर हो रहा है, क्योंकि आप एक ही स्टेटस के लोग हैं, कोई आपको डर नहीं है, तो यहाँ पर गॉसिप शुरू हो जाते हैं, यहाँ से ही रूमर्स बाहर निकलते हैं. सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल. इनफैक्ट व्हेन यू आर विद द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और इवन इन फैमिली, व्हेन यू ऑल इक्वल एज ग्रुप पीपल सिट, यू सी यू यूजली गॉसिप किसने क्या किया, क्यों किया, कैसे किया और क्या उसका इफेक्ट होना है, और उसमें हम मजा भी लेने लगते हैं. सो वेदर इट्स अ फैमिली थिंग और इट्स अ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन थिंग, द इक्वल सोशल स्टेटस, मेंटली, एजुकेशन, एवरीथिंग, इफ इट्स इक्वालिटी, द रूमर्स जनरेट. सो यू हैव टू अवॉइड दैट सिचुएशन एंड कॉन्शियसली अवॉइड इट. मतलब सोच समझ के उस ग्रुप में उन गॉसिप्स को अवॉइड करो, और बिकॉज दीज आर टाइम वेस्टिंग, एंड उनमें से कोई एक जना भी आपकी बात कन्वे कर देता है, द होल मिस इंटरप्रिटेशन टेक्स प्लेस, और आपको ये टाइम ही लग जाएगा कहते कहते कि मैंने एचआर मैनेजर को क्यों कहा कि वो खड़ूस है. सो लेट्स नॉट गेट इन टू द गेट इन टू रूमर्स एंड टू इन टू द कम्युनिकेशन विच जनरेट ऑल दिस गॉसिप्स. देर इज अ ग्रेप वाइन कम्युनिकेशन विच इज एक्चुअली केम फ्रॉम द वर्ड, आई मीन व्हेन व्हेन आफ्टर ड्रंक, व्हेन यू आर लिटिल ड्रंक एंड यू स्टार्ट बैक बाइटिंग और यू स्टार्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट अदर्स, दैट्स व्हेन द कम्युनिकेशन हैपन्स एंड इट ब्रिंग्स अ लॉट ऑफ डिस्टर्बेंस. इट इज बेसिकली अ सबकॉन्शियस अर्ज जो आप पे सेडिस्टिक, आपको वो किसी मजा लेती है जब किसी को दर्द होता है और किसी के बारे में बुराइयां करते हैं, ये एक बहुत मजे की फीलिंग होती है, और ये आप अपने इमोशंस, हेट्रेड के इमोशंस, फ्रस्ट्रेशन के, प्लेजर के, सारे इमोशंस आप रिलीज करते हैं जब आप किसी की पीठ पीछे बुराई करते हैं, और बहुत ही मजा आता है इसमें, बहुत जो करने वाले लोग हैं उनको बहुत ही मजा आता है. लेकिन द फैक्ट इज दैट यू हैव टू अवॉइड दिस स्पेशली इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस एंड पर्सनल लाइफ ऑल्सो, क्योंकि कभी वो सामने आ जाए तो बहुत लेने के देने पड़ जाते हैं. सो हाउ टू ओवरकम अ ग्रेप वाइन काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन व्हेन यू आर गेटिंग इन साइड द बैक बाइटिंग एंड व्हेन यू आर गेटिंग इन साइड द बैक स्टैबिंग, की जो पीछे पीछे जब आप किसी के पीठ पीछे जब बात करते हो तो कैसे उससे, हाउ टू ओवरकम दैट स्पेशली इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, because we are talking business organization, you all going to be soon graduates and you are going to step into a different world and you should know ki jab jaise jaise youngsters aate to hum jo ragging karte hain waise hi ye cheeze communication wali us ragging se bachne ke liye aapko bataya ja raha hai ki kyun kis tarah ke communication hote hain organization mein aur aapko kaise bachna chahiye aur aana chahiye un situations ko deal karna. सो इनको हम ओवरकम करने के लिए फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इन एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट्स अ रूल, रूल नंबर वन, यू हैव टू थिंक बिफोर यू टॉक. आप कहेंगे ये तो बचपन से सुन रहे हैं, सभी कहते हैं, टीचर भी बोलती आई है, मम्मी पापा भी बोलते आए हैं, सब बोलते आए हैं, तो सब बोलते आए हैं तो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जैसे ही आप नौकरी कर रहे हैं तो आप करना भी शुरू कर दें, क्योंकि एक शब्द निकला हुआ वो जरूर घूम कर कई बूमरैंग की तरह वापस आता है और उसका मतलब बदल चुका होता है. लाइक आई टोल्ड यू, कम्युनिकेशन इज वेरी गुड इफ इट इज इंटरप्रेटेड इज द इन द सेम मैनर व्हाट यू वांटेड टू कन्वे, बट इफ इट इज मिस इंटरप्रेटेड देन इट बिकम्स सो मच डिफिकल्ट टू गैप द डिफरेंस. सो थिंक बिफोर यू टॉक. एज एन एडल्ट यू ऑल विल बी इंजीनियर्स, they'll be engineers and you'll all will be engineers, and that which is a very responsible job or whichever job you take up from now on, be very careful, be cautious about it and learn the signs that you are the target. Aur hamesha jab ye backbiting hoti hai to aapko pata chalna chahiye ki kya signs hai ki main target bana hua hu, kahin mere pe to nahi backbiting ho rahi hai. So signs kya hai, jab aap kahin jao aur dusre चुप हो जाए, ओके, और आपको पता चले कि जैसे ही आप हट रहे हो तो खुसफुस फिर शुरू हो जाए, हो सकता है कि इंटरनेट पे आपके लिए कुछ ना कुछ छोड़ दिया जाए, हो सकता है किसी के थ्रू आपको ये कन्वे किया जाए कि आप क्या कर रहे हैं, हो सकता है अचानक ही आपके सीनियर को आप पे गुस्सा आ जाए, हो सकता है कि आपका जूनियर आपसे बात करना बंद कर दे. तो ये तभी जब ये अचानक चीजें होती हैं तो वॉच आउट कि शायद कहीं आप तो टारगेट नहीं बन गए हो, बैक बाइटिंग है, कोई आपके पीछे आपकी पीठ के पीछे तो नहीं आपके काम के बारे में या पर्सनल करेक्टर एनालिसिस असैसिनेशन तो नहीं कर रहा है. जस्ट लर्न दैट वंस यू आर इन एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. लर्न फ्रॉम पास्ट विक्टम्स एक्सपीरियंसेस. इन एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन देयर आर ऑफकोर्स द पॉलिसीज आर देयर एंड द रिस्पॉन्सिबल पीपल आर देयर ऑन ईच पोस्ट, बट it always shows that few people, for example, there is a person called Mr. Subhash, and he is a good senior HR person, but the employees before you and who have been in that company have suffered from his hand. He is A, very knowledgeable, he knows his work and is close to the management. But somewhere you learn that he has become vindictive, जिनको win-win हमेशा ही जीतने का शौक है और अपना point prove करने का शौक है without seeing कि दूसरे की feelings hurt हो रही हैं या वो क्या चाह रहा है, क्योंकि ultimately we work with people. Always remember, when we are talking about organization, whether you are in IT, whether you are in doctor, whether you are teacher, whether you are in media, or whether you are working on your own with any as a trade person, you have your own shop, you have your own business, but we are basically dealing with people. So communication starts with people and feedback of people, right? So be very careful that Mr. Subhash has already played up with other people and now you may be the target. So because he gets a sadistic pleasure when to disturb any new employee, and this is what they have been saying. Later on he settles down with them, but that's he is, and somehow management is also ignoring that. So what do you do? You learn from victim's experience and avoid such situation so that you are not involved in any of the rumors or backbites and you don't become the target. Watch for them. आप देखिए कि किस तरह से दूसरों के साथ बिहेव किया जा रहा है, सीनियर्स का और जूनियर्स का क्या रिश्ता है एक कंपनी, बिकॉज ईच एंड एवरी कंपनी हैज प्रॉपर कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट and how they conduct it and what is their requirements and what how big is a company and how many people is under one company department. Everything affects this. So watch for them, people who are backbiters. So like they say that ignorance is no excuse. आपसे गलती होने के बाद अगर आप ये कहें मुझे तो पता ही नहीं था, in business world this is no excuse. If you are hired, then you should know that by these steps, you should know how to get the information and get the work done. Excuse, ignorance is no excuse in any organization that you didn't know. No, you are hired for that. You should know. Ask, and ask whoever, but get the work done. This is the rule of any organization, and organizations is basically profit driven. They are the one who need money, and how will you cultivate convert everything, all skills and everything into money unless until it is done in right way, right time and rightly communicated. So you have to watch out that and not to be ignorant. Distance yourself. They say that for the grapevine, for such backbiting and for such kind of behavior, just if you recognize that group, that ye group hai jo har lunch pe char jane baith jate hain aur dusre ka mazak karte hain ya neecha dikhane ki koshish karte hain ya